टुडे प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर मनोज कुमार विल गिव लेक्चर ऑन द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन एंड द सेल्स मैनेजमेंट, सेल्स एंड द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन मैनेजमेंट एंड दिस टॉपिक विल बी डिस्कस्ड टुडे एंड ही विल गिव द लेक्चर ऑन दिस यूनिट. In the case of this model one, in the unit one, overview of the personal selling, unit two, sales force management, unit three, sales management and market potential selling function of the salesman, unit four, search for the sales opportunity, information gathering function of the salesman, unit five, quality of the good salesman and principles of the salesmanship. These are the topics of the module one. Overview of the personal selling, sales force management, sales management and the market potential selling function of the salesman, search for the sales opportunity, information gathering function of the salesman, quality of the good salesman and principles of the salesmanship. Module two, Unit 1, Sales Force Organization. Unit 2, Recruiting and Selecting Sales Personnel. Unit 3, Planning and Conducting Sales Training Program. Unit 4, Sales Technique. Unit 5, Motivating Sales Personnel. Module 3, Unit 1, Sales Meeting and the Sales Contest. Unit 2, Assigning Sales Personnel to the Sales Territory. Unit 3, Controlling Sales Effort. Unit 4, Sales Budget. Unit 5, Sales Quota. Module 4, Sales Analysis and Control. Unit 2, Quantity Method for the Sales Management Decision, Sales Forecasting. Unit 3, Ethical and Social Responsibility of the Salesman and Sales Manager. These are the topic of this one. The main contents are also given here. Contents: Module 1, Unit 1, Overview of the Personal Selling. Unit 2, Sales Force Management. Unit 3, Sales Management and the Market Potential Selling Function of the Salesman. Unit 4, Search for the Sales Opportunity, Information Gathering Function of the Salesman. Unit 5, Quality of the Good Salesman and Principle of the Salesmanship. Unit 1, Sales Force Organization. Unit 2, Recruiting and Selecting Sales Personnel. Unit 3, Planning and Conducting Sales Training Program. Unit 4, Sales Technique. Unit 5, Motivating Sales Personnel. Module 3, Sales Meeting and the Sales Contest. Unit 2, Assigning Sales Personnel to the Sales Territory. Unit 3, Controlling Sales Effort. Unit 4, Sales Budget. Unit 5, Sales Quota. Module 4, Unit 1, Sales Analysis and Control. Unit 2, Quantity Method for the Sales Management Decision, Sales Forecasting. Ethical and Social Responsibility of the Salesman and the Sales Manager. These are the units of the module. Unit 1, Overview of the Personal Selling. Here, in this case, introduction, objective, main contents, importance, and real role of the sales force, conclusion, summary, tutor mark assignment, reference, and other readings will be discussed. A popular slogan in marketing says that nothing happens until a sale is made. This statement is supported by the region and experience. The typical firm can be seen as an input-output system, having previously ascertained what the buyer's wants are, specification and requirement, it translates these into product concept and finally into goods and services capable of satisfying the identified want. It is not sufficient to produce output that can satisfy human wants. These must be properly priced and made available when and where they are needed. All these, however, will still not ensure that the exchange takes place and the buyer takes possession and ownership while the firm earns income revenue. there is a need for the communication in the process of the which awareness is created, desires are aroused, and prospects or customer are persuaded that a particular product being offered has the greatest potential to satisfy their consumption need, and the benefit of using the product outweighs the cost of acquiring it. Party in exchange relation must be capable of communication for marketing to the take place. Personal selling is located in the communication aspects of the marketing. The other aspect of this communication or the marketing proposition are advertising, sales promotion, and publicity. These other aspects individually and collectively work to water the ground, so to say, for personal selling by informing, persuading, and reminding target customer about the firm and its offering. Personal selling is, generally speaking, one of the tools of the marketing proposition, or the what is the commonly called promo tools. It is a unique promo tool in the sense that it is the marketing function with the wondrous task of ultimately converting the outputs of the organizer. To case, it is the point of the personal selling that the organization marketing efforts either fails or succeed. At this point, the prospect is converted to a customer, or the customer accepts to buy, continues to buy, or refuses to buy. Objectives. At the end of this unit, you should be able to discuss the role and importance of the sales force in an organization. Describe the two broad categories of the salesman and expand the role of the personal selling within the overall protocols of an organization. Main content, importance, and role of the sales force. The whole essence of the marketing has been established to be the transaction, defined as the exchange of value between the two parties. If exchange is at the center of the marketing, then the personal selling occupies a preeminent position in the marketing. It is the marketing function or activity that identifies prospective buyer and pursue them to the physically to exchange perhaps their money with the output of the firm. It is at that point of the personal selling that marketing is consummated, a sale is made, and revenue is realized by the firm, and the consumer takes ownership and possession of the firm's output. While it can be said that the marketing is the breadwinner in the firm, it is obvious that the personal selling is the bread getter. One is not in any way suggesting that the personal selling is the most important of the all marketing activity. It is a part of the total marketing effort, a very crucial and decisive part. One can say personal selling brings the buyer and the seller into the direct contact. The interaction that takes place at this point is the heart of the marketing, representing and market transaction with its inherent issue of the exchange and the value. Every organization must have one or more person whose responsibility it is to ensure that the customer and or prospects are contacted and convinced to accept the value offered in exchange for a value desired by the organization. Such person entrusted with task of the effecting market transaction make up the sales force of the organization. The sales force is indispensable in the organization. There is no amount of the advertising, sales promotion, or publicity that make up for the personal selling. Someone somewhere must establish contact with the buyers for the market transaction to take place. Indeed, nothing happens in the organization until a salesperson sells something. The course of the personal selling has been identified as locating of the prospective customer, converting them to the buyer, and ensuring the satisfaction. This, however, does not fully explain the role of the sales force. The sales force in modern marketing is not only concerned with the selling function, dealing primarily with the current sales, but also is concerned with laying the foundation for future sales through the performance of the information gathering function. The sales force is indeed the link between the organization and their customer. Salesmen have dual responsibility in the many respect. They pass information in the form of the message from the organization to customer and bring back report from the customer to the organization feedback. Salesmen also have to ensure that the organization realize profit from the sales and those customer derive adequate satisfaction from the buying organization output. The good salesman is the one who succeeds in discharging his responsibility to hold his organization as customer. This needs careful handling. The successful sale is that which brings profit to organization and at the same time provides adequate satisfaction to the buyers or the customer. We have used salesmen so far referred to the those engaged in the personal selling. You will be find different terms in the other books. Perhaps because of the increasing involvement of the women in the personal selling, people are arguing that the term salesman is inappropriate to describe all personal in the personal selling. The distorted and the transmit image of the salesman is a more convincing reason why people in personal selling are asking to be called by the other names. The new terms used to describe people in the personal selling are the salesperson, sales representative, field representative, sales consultant, market representative, account executives, manufacturer's representative, agents, and the service representative. Salesmen don't all face the same selling situation or the task. The role of a salesman will play dependent on the selling situation or task before him. Based on this, we can describe two broad category of the salesman. These are the order takers and the order getters, makers. The order taking situation obtains where the buyer has previous experience of the product, and the function of the salesman is to price the product specified, take the payment, and the effect delivery. In order making situation, the buyer has no previous experience of the product and is actively seeking information or has only an ill-defined or limited demand for the product to fill a given need. In these instances, the salesman will be challenged to identify and locate the potential buyer or prospect and convert them to the buyers. We can also classify salesmen on the basis of the position they occupy. The following classification of the sales position was offered. Delivery salesman, inside order taker, field order taker. The salesman here predominantly delivers product to the buyers. The salesman stands behind the counter and sells buyer. The salesman is predominantly an order taker but goes outside to meet the buyers. Missionary salesman. This salesman does not do direct selling but calls on the actual or potential user, educating them and building goodwill for his organization. Technical salesman. The salesman selling basically technical goods and offering technical services. Good salesman, salesman involved in creative sale of the tangible products. Service salesman, salesman involved in the creative sale of services is insurance. Conclusion, the role of the sales force in organization is very important and central in realizing their corporate objective. The selling function is the breadwinner in the organization, and the associated tasks in achieving the revenue realization are performed by different classes of the salesmen. Summary, in this unit, the importance, role of the sales force, and the different position they occupy in the organization are discussed. Tutor marked assignment classifies salesmen on the basis of the position they occupy. Based on the selling situation or task him, describe the two broad category of the salesman. Discuss the role of the sales force in the marketing organization. These are the references and the further reading. Unit 2, sales force management. The contents are the introduction, objective, main content, sales management, sales force interface, key aspects of the sales management, conclusion, summary, tutor market assignment, references, further reading. Introduction. Put simply, sales management is the management of the sales force of an organization. We have noted that the sales force has the responsibility for contacting buyers and making sales. So what about sales management? Objective: at the end of this unit, you should be able to define sales management, explain the interface of the sales force with or other organizational function, and discuss the key aspect of the sales management. Main content: sales management. The need for the proper management of the sales force derive from three important considerations. Selling is a key marketing function. It deserves proper management if the other marketing efforts of the organization are to be meaningful. All the efforts of the management in producing one satisfying product, pricing them well, ensuring their ability when they are needed, and achieving reasonable promotion through the use of the advertising. Sales promotion and publicity will not ensure a market transaction if there is a mistake at the point of the interaction between the buyer and the representative of the selling organization. This crucial function deserves proper function. The sales objective of the organization are very important in achieving the overall objective of organization. For a business to make profit, it must realize total revenue in excess of its total cost. Revenue realization logically is the bottom line of the personal selling. If business profit depends crucially on total revenue, then attention should be paid to the activity whose essence is the revenue realization. The cost of the personal selling is almost very high. It is more than the cost of the other promo tools added together. As a major cost center, it deserves adequate attention, as many reduction in the cost of the achieved through the effective and efficient management will improve the organization's profit position. Often organization have many people in their sales force. Selling many products and serving large markets in terms of the size, geographical spread, and the differences in the customer buying characteristics, it become necessary, therefore, for the organization to mobilize the sales force or effective coverage of the market and to ensure that all products receive due attention. All these must be done properly if the sales objective of the organization must be realized. This calls for the good management of the sales force. We can therefore define sales management as the organizational effort necessary in the planning sales objective, specifying sales effort needed in realizing the objectives, selecting, training, and motivating appropriate sales force, and controlling their operation towards ensuring full realization of the sales objective. The sales manager is that person who manages the sales force of an organization. He effectively uses the sales force to sell the products produced by the organization. Of course, the sales manager is a member of the organization sales force. We have deliberately used the word organization to highlight the fact that the personal selling and the salesman are found and needed in organization that have to interact and pursue people to accept their offering. Sales force interface. It must be noted that the sales force alone cannot realize the sales objective of an organization. Sales effort must be complemented with the efforts of the other organization function personnel. The sales force need for support for the following. Top management: the direct efforts of the salesman in realizing sales objective are often facilitated by the policy adopted by the top management to support them. Organizational decision in the areas of the product quality and the availability, advertising, pricing, and after sales service have impact on the performance of the salesman. Technical salesperson in actual face-to-face interaction between the salesman and customer prospects, the former are expected to be persuasive. This requires being acknowledgeable about the product, its usage, benefits, and characteristics. Some of this information is technical and best provided by the personnel in production and research and development department. The cooperation of these technical personnel is therefore important for the successful personal selling. Maintenance, installation, and allied service personnel. Salesmen ordinarily depend on the assistance of these specialized personnel in the solving the problems of the customer and achieving successful selling. Office staff. Some people in the office of the selling organization don't make contact with the customer but help in meeting their order. Example of such people are sales analysts, order expediter, and the secretarial person. Key aspects of the sales management. The key aspects of the sales management are the sales planning, sales organization and recruitment, selection and training of the salesman, compensation of the salesman and control of the salesman, involving establishment of standard, supervision, performance evaluation and the corrective action. These aspects are the key tasks of the sales manager are discussed briefly. Sales planning. In sales planning, the sales manager working in concert with the marketing manager and the top management is expected to come with his sales forecast for a given business period. Because salesmen have the direct responsibility of realizing the sales forecast of the firm, they should be involved in doing it. The sales forecast figure represents the expected sales figure for firms and forms the basis for all organizational planning. Organizational budgeting, production schedule, and the purchasing schedule depend largely on the sales forecasting. It also defines what the organization expects of the sales force. Once the level of the sales expected to be achieved by the sales force is known, it falls on the sales manager to plan on how to achieve the target. It becomes necessary then for the sales manager to estimate the amount of the selling effort needed to achieve the desired sales target. Within this round, the sales manager will be able to know the number of the salesmen needed for the realization of the target. Based largely on the expected sales target, the sales manager will be allocated quota to his salesmen. The aggregate of the quota should be at least equal to the expected sales target. The traditional method of stating objective in terms of the sales volume or the sales force has been criticized. If salesmen concentrate primarily on the sales volume, they may be neglect the cost achieving such a target to the detriment of the organization's profitability. The better way of stating sales force objective or target is in terms of the contribution to the profit. If a salesman is given a profit level as the sales target, he will be better minded to consider selling cost with a view to minimizing it while maximizing sales volume. Whether stated in terms of the profit or sales volume, sales target for the salesman can be expressed by the product for a company selling two or more products, by the territory for a company operating in a large block market, and that can be split into the sales territory, and by the customers for a company selling to the many customer type, for example, end user, reselling buyers, industry buyers, institutional buyers, and the government buyers. Sales organization. In this, the sales manager decides on how best to mobilize the salesman working for him and through whom he will realize the sales objective of the organization. The essence of the sales organization is to achieve an optimum deployment of the sales force and effective coverage of the sales market. Salesmen can be organized along the lines of the geography, product or customer, or a combination of the two or more of them. Recruitment, selection, and training of the salesman. All these are discussed under the personal function of the sales manager. They often also are the direct responsibility of the organization personal manager. In the case of the salesman, however, the sales manager should have a say in the type of the people to be employed and how they will be trained, since they will work directly under him, and the salesmanship is not likely other organizational job. In suggesting the type of the people to be employed as a salesman, the sales manager should be guided by the following: the kinds of the customer they will deal with, the kinds of the product they will sell, the possession of the some characteristics common to the successful salesman. The sales manager also has to ensure that the right people employed as salesmen are given requisite training that will prepare them for the challenges they will encounter in the field. It must be noted that both old and new salesmen need training. The initial training for the new salesman will be to impart basic selling skills and knowledge into them. The continuous training that will be for all salesmen will be tailored towards meeting specific training needs of the sales force, as the sales manager will ascertain from time to time. Motivation of the salesman. One of the greatest responsibility of the sales manager is the need to motivate his salesmen to the maximum effort as noted in the student aid notebook, the sales manager skill in motivating his sales force will determine the degree of the success he achieves in his job. Proper motivation of the sales force requires that the sales manager should appreciate the peculiarity of the each selling job. The satisfaction delivered, therefore, and ensure that they are made available to the sales force as much as possible. An adequately motivated sales force will be satisfied, one willing to give the maximum effort and to the glory of the organization. Conclusion: the generally accepted factor that motivate salesmen, which are the sales manager should consider, are the money, recognition, sense of the belonging, opportunity for the progress, authority, exemplary leadership, good condition of the work, effective communication, and the security. Summary: in this unit, you have been exposed of the following: explanation of the sales management, discussion of the sales force interface in the organization, and discussion of the key aspects of the sales management. Tutor mark assignment: discuss the four related process that the problem of the control reduces to in the sales management. List and explain the major personal function of the sales manager. References and the further reading. These are the references and the further reading. Unit 3, sales management and market potential. Selling function of the salesman. What are the selling function of the salesman? The contents are the introduction, objective, main content, selling function of the salesman, the selling function, conclusion, summary, tutor mark assignment, references, further reading. The function salesmen perform are the many and varied. One can only discuss the function of the salesman in a general sense. Objective: at the end of this unit, you should be able to discuss the selling function of the salesman and list and explain the specific responsibility of the salesman to their buyers and the organization. Main content: selling function of the salesman. There are some situation-specific factors that make the function of the salesman to differ. Some of these factors are the sales position, jobs. Based on sales position, even different selling situations are identified. These are positions where the salesman is predominantly an inside order taker. Position where the salesman is predominantly to deliver goods, deliver salesman. Position where the salesman is predominantly an inside order taker but works in the field, field order taker. Position requiring the salesman only to build goodwill or to educate the actual or potential buyer or missionary salesman. Position requiring the salesman to sell only technical products, engineering, or the technical salesman. Position requiring only the creative sales of the tangibles, I order getting goods salesman. Position which demand the creative sales of the tangibles, I order getting service salesman. Based on the sales job, four different selling situations are identified, namely trade selling, missionary selling, technical selling, new business selling. The different sales position jobs require the salesman to perform somewhat different function or the degree of the function. The other factors are the buying situation faced by the customer or the organization. The customer faces three buying situations. These are the extensive problem solving situation, limited problem solving situation, and routinized responsive behavior situation. An organization will face the following buying situation: straight rebuy, modified reward, and the new task. Buyer status: they are first time buyer and the regular buyer. Purchase occasion: there are regular and special purchase occasions. Type of the buyer: there are end-user buyer and industrial buyer. Industrial buyers are of the many types. These include reseller buyers, government buyers, institutional buyers, and the industry buyer. Primary objective of the selling organization: let us simply say that there are two types of organization. Which business or profit-making organization and the other non-profit-making organization. Behavioral traits of the buyer: buyers will be normally fall into any of these category: hostile, timid, angry, indifferent, skeptical, hesitant, and friendly. State of readiness of the buyer: the different states are unaware, aware, informed, interested, desirous, intended to buy, testing, and regular buyer. nature of the product. Based on the use to which the product is put, it has been classified into the consumer goods and the industrial goods. Consumer goods have traditionally been classified as conveniences, shopping, and specialty on the basis of the consumer shopping effort. Five category of the industrial goods have been identified. These are the raw material, component part and material, major capital equipment, accessory equipment, and operating supply. We see from the presentation above that a number of the factors ranging from the role of the salesman play in organization, the nature and type of the buyer, the limits, the nature of the product he sells, and to the buying situation of the customer interact to define what the function or role of the expectation to the salesman should be. In general sense, however, the salesman is a vital link between an organization and its market. In this role, the salesman discharges some important responsibility to his organization and his actual and potential buyer. The function of the salesman will be better appreciated when viewed in terms of the dual responsibility they serve and their role as a link between organization and the markets. The specific responsibility of salesmen to their organization have been identified to include representation of this firm to its customer. In this capacity, the salesman tries to enhance the employer's name and further his business in the territory assigned to him. They are expected to exploit fully the potential of the present customer to the benefit of their organization. They are to identify cumulative and secure new customer for their organization. They are expected to bring back relevant information on the product, competition, customers, etc. to their organization. The specific responsibility of salesmen to their buyers are the helping them to accept and define their problem, assisting them to clarify their problem and identify alternative solution to them, helping them to come to the right decision, that is, buying the product with the greatest potential to meet their needs. This the salesman will do by providing truthful purchasing information to the buyer. The salesman also have the responsibility of ensuring the continued satisfaction of the needs of their buyers. They do this by providing after-sales services and other relevant information on the installation, use, and maintenance of the purchased products. Be he an order taker or getter, a service or good, new or old, machinery or the new business salesman, in whatever position or situation he finds himself, the good salesman is expected to perform a combination of some or all the under-listed tasks. The presentation, demonstration, and sale of his company goods, negotiation on price, quantity, and delivery, explanation and presentation of company policy. The continuous examination of the market and reporting on the commodity methods, product and prices. Reporting on shortage, oversupply, and changes in trading condition. The relating to his company of the any information of the general commercial value. The maintenance of the adequate stock of his company's goods by the distributor and the user. Care in the ensuring that customer keep the goods under suitable shortage condition. The advice and instruction of the dealer and their staff on the sale and display of his company's product. The continuous acquisition of the knowledge of his company's product and their application, selling point, and the benefit to the user. Prospecting for the new outlet and the new businesses and the extension of his company's influence on his territory. The obtaining and maintenance of the satisfactory displays for his company's goods. The maintenance of good customer relation, recommendation of credit for the customer, assessment of their premises, organization sending and influence in the trade and acquisition of the satisfactory trade references, the collection of the outstanding accounts and avoidance of the bad debts, the handling of the complaint from the distributor and user, implementation of the sales promotion schemes, the maintenance of the satisfactory records of the customer's business with his company and the expeditious handling of the correspondence, the proper care and maintenance of any of his company's property which has been entrusted to his charge. These tasks will reduce the two-class categorization of the function of the salesman. The two traditional and generally accepted functions are the selling function and the information gathering function. Each function is important as the other. The argument that the salesmen are very expensive is often advanced by the sales manager who don't know to fully utilize the labor of their salesmen. Such sales manager may be viewing the function of the salesman narrowly. Only in terms of the sales they can generate immediately. Sales manager are advised to recognize that salesmen are an important source of the marketing intelligence. While selling function is very important and provides immediate sales, the salesman, if well trained and motivated, will provide management with valid and reliable information that will form the basis for the management decision and guarantee future sales. Using salesmen as a source of the marketing intelligence will increase their usefulness and reduce their effective cost. The selling function, put simply, the bottom line of the selling function, that is personal selling in most creative form, is identifying prospect and converting them to the customer. It has been described as searching for the needers, changing them to the wanters, and finally to the buyers. The salesman who does this effectively is the one who succeeds in guiding the potential buyer through a number of the mental processes, leading to acceptance first of the idea that he is an unfulfilled need, then the idea that the pro-offered product will be beneficial to him, then that of the idea that the benefits outweighs the cost, then of the conviction that the pro-offered product is better than the alternative was in terms of the benefit and cost, and finally to the action. Identifying the potential buyer, converting them to buyer, and maintaining them for the not simple task, successful salesmen will tell you that they perform a number of the logical tasks in achieving this. Some of these necessary tasks will include defining and locating prospect. The task here is prospecting. Learning everything about the product. This will entail gathering essential information that will aid the salesman in defining the needs of his prospect and establishing an objective or average sales called his mistake. With the needs of the prospect, now an objective set for the sales call. The salesman will feel confident in selecting the appropriate mix of the presentation variable to use in the attaining the objective of the call. The task of doing all these is called call planning or the pre-approach. Now, next task approach will be to create the right atmosphere that will draw the attention and hold the interest of the prospect before the salesman goes to the stage of discussing the business with the prospect. Achieving this will require the following. The salesman should book appointment where possible. Be properly dressed. This dressing must be neat and suitable for the occasion. Introduce himself if he is not known. Behave and conduct him in a manner acceptable to the prospect. Be punctual. Use the language he is proficient in and that is agreeable to the prospect. Converting prospectus into the buyer's customer. This is achieved through the objective performance of the task of the presentation, trial closing, uncovering objection, handling objection, and closing. Maintenance of the customer. It is not sufficient to convert prospect into the customer. That customer must be maintained by the adequate assurance of the continued satisfaction of their need. Maintenance involves a number of the related follow-up activity conducting to the provision of the after-sale services, installation, repair, and information on the use of the purchased product. Conclusion. Salesmen perform two broad type of the function in this or their organization. These are the selling function and information gathering function. In this unit, the selling function of the salesman were discussed. Summary, in this unit, you have been exposed the following. The selling function of the salesman, different sales position jobs, four different selling situations, specific responsibility of the salesman to their organization and the customers, the core salesman selling function. Tutor mark assignment, discuss the selling function of the salesman, list and explain the specific responsibility and salesman and their buyers. References reading are the further is given there. Unit 4, search for the sales opportunity information gathering function of the salesman. Introduction, objective, main content, information gathering function of the salesman. Sources of the marketing information, salesman and marketing information gathering, types of the information salesman gather. conclusion, summary, tutor marked assignment, references for the reading. Personal staging is a form of communication that effectively links the company and its customer. This linkage role serves as a strategic function in bringing a company and its customer together and meeting their expectation and demand. This role is growing in importance as product market become increasingly competitive and customer more acknowledgeable and discriminatory. Objectives. At the end of this unit, you should be able to discuss the information gathering function of the salesman. List and explain the specific roles of the information flow from the customer to the producer within the framework of marketing management and describe the type of the information sales gather. Main content, information gathering function of the salesman. In this dynamic and complex marketing environment, organizations are becoming more conscious of the need to bridge the information gap between them and their customers. The quality of the information available to the organization will determine the appropriateness of the decision they take in response to the challenges posed by the interacting environmental factors with a view to meeting the expectation and demands of their customer and achieving their corporate objective. Bridging the information gap that exists between the organization and their customer become a crucial function that marketing must perform. This information gap, it must be noted, has two dimensions to it. There is the information that needs to flow from the customer to the producer. This information is, for all practical purposes, central to the successful marketing. If modern marketing, as is asserted, starts with the consumers and ends with the consumers, then information flow from consumer to the producer is the logical starting point in the marketing process. This information expertly will tell that the producer that goods consumer want, how they want them, where they want them, and when reliably want them. This information, if validity collected and interpreted, will be guarantee and the outputs of the product meet the specification and requirements of the customer and therefore likely to be accepted by them. This information will also be answer the key marketing question as to how to distribute, price, and promote the output of the producers. Information flow from customer to producer is not limited to the situation discussed above. At various times in the life of any organization, at any stage of the life of the product of the organization, information flow from the customer is important. If the product starts experiencing declining sales, losing its market share, or is increasing being returned by the buyers, management is faced with a serious problem that the couch of and solution to must be found only from the customers and the consumers. It is only these people that can give information on the basis of the which solution can be found for the problem. The specific roles of the information flow from consumer to the producer within the framework of marketing management have been identified to include. Monitoring the environment. The elements of the marketing environment are ever-changing, are largely outside the control of the marketer. The most marketer can do, since these elements define the opportunity and challenges in the marketer, is to monitor the changing environment, that is, the collect information about the nature and direction of the changing environmental elements and adopt appropriately to them. Implementation of the marketing concept. Given that marketing concept stresses consumer satisfaction, it becomes necessary for organizations that want to implement the concept to collect information on the needs and desires of the buyer to guide their decision on the product, pricing, promotion, and the disruption. Formation and evolution of the market segment. Market segmentation is a modern marketing procedure that recognizes that markets are largely heterogeneous and cannot be served efficiently with one product. It seeks to split the heterogeneous block market into the seemingly. Being homogeneous, it is conceptually believed to be the capable of being served efficiently with one product or the marketing mix. The splitting of the markets, however, should not be done avidly. It requires information about consumers on variables to be used for the exercise. Demand assessment. Estimation of the current and future sale is normally based on the trend of the factor that influence demand. Information on the trend of the demand influencing factor need to be obtained from the consumers, among other sources. evolution of the marketing tactics. Marketers use a mix of the marketing decision variable to appeal to their target market. The levels of the variables to be used, such as price and promotion, will need to be set and from time to time measured with a view to determining how they are contributing to the success of the marketing program. This information will help management in reviewing its marketing program when necessary. Control. The need for control in strategic marketing is important. Control involves setting standards of the performance, monitoring or supervising the performance of the worker, measurement of the actual performance against expected performance, and taking corrective measures where and necessary. Information is needed in setting performance standard and making assessment of the performance level. Sources of the marketing information. There are the many sources through which marketers collect all the information they need for the intelligent decision making. These sources are commonly grouped into four making of a marketing information system. These are the internal accounting system, marketing intelligence system, marketing research system, and the marketing management science or the operation research system. Internal accounting system is the earliest and the most basic information system used by the marketing executive. It reports orders, sales, inventory, labels, receivables, payables, etc. While marketing intelligence system is described as day-to-day information concerning pertinent and development in the environment, primarily the competitive sector. This is the way in which the company executives are kept current and informed about the changing condition in the macro environment and task environment. Marketing executives can collect intelligence information on their own from their salesmen, dealers, and specialized marketing research firm. Marketing research as a component of the marketing information system provides marketing executive with the pertinent information for solving marketing problem and taking advantage of the market opportunity. It has been formally defined as the systematic and objective search for and analysis of the information relevant to the identification and solution of the marketing problem. The fourth component of the marketing information system, that is the operation research, relies on the application of the scientific methodology to the organizational problem in the search of the improved understanding, prediction, and control. This system, though new, has yielded useful insight and decision model in such area as new product development, competitive pricing, advertising, budgeting, and media selection, sales call time allocation, and marketing mix planning. Salesman and marketing information gathering. Of the four sources of the marketing information or the components of the marketing information system, salesmen are credible and dependable provider of the three. They are largely responsible for gathering large amount of the valid and reliable marketing intelligence. As organization frontline soldiers, contact point between the organization and their buyers, dealers, and competitors, organization eye and ears to be the marketplace. Salesmen are in a vantage position to collect and supply marketing executive with valuable information that keeps them well informed of happening in the marketplace and capable of developing appropriate marketing proposal or a strategy for tackling immediate problem and drawing up future marketing plans. The information that emanates from the internal accounting system is largely based on the activity and reports of the salesman. Accounting system report essentially sales information. The heart of the accounting system is the order shipping billing cycle. Order getting being in the main a selling function means that the salesmen are largely responsible for the gathering of the data with which accounting system work and from which they produce valuable sales information. Marketing research as a scientific process involves a number of the stages, including the recognition of the need of the research, problem definition, statement of the research objective, research design, data collection, tabulation and analysis of the data, interpretation of the result, preparation and presentation of a report and feedback. The data collection stage of the survey research almost always entails a field work. In this, some interviewer will need to make contact with the respondent or the interview of customer of the organization with whom salesmen have been established relation. Salesmen are arguably practicing interviewers as their selling job requires that they are more or less interview their customer and or prospect. Even if they are not professional interviewers, elite training can put salesmen in a good footing to collect any information with whatever research instrument in use from the customer, prospect, turn research respondent. Many companies I know use their salesmen in administrating questionnaire on their buyers. The use of the salesman in doing this will only be inappropriate if the company is conducting a disguised survey and will not want it identified to be known. Type of information salesmen gather. We have noted that the salesmen gather a wide array of the marketing information that is useful to the marketing management. This section of this chapter will discuss the specific area of the marketing in which the salesmen make report that contain facts and opinion which provide marketing management and the background information upon which the immediate and future planning decisions are made. These areas include the following. Product problems report. Most products experience one form of the problem and another in their life cycle. The problem may be unknown to research and development and production personnel in the organization. Often, however, the problem may not be apparent but known to these personnel in the organization, but they will be unwilling to report it because of the vested interest. Once a product gets to the market, however, its defect cannot be hidden or covered for long. If resale customer don't report such problem, consumer certainly would salesman as the representative or organization that customer know will always be the first to get such a report. Salesman cannot wish away or ignore such negative occurrences. It will not be in their interest to pretend that a product problem does not exist. It will affect their performance remarkably as buyers will refuse to buy the defective product. Product problem can be in the following area: quality, packaging, performance, expiration, decoration, weight, frequent breakdown, chemical makeup, etc. As salesmen receive report on the product problem, they are expected to render verbal and written feedback to the management on the basis of the which measure which will be taken to solve the problem reported. Such reports will be include some recommendation solution can cause a product to be substantially modified, changed or withdrawn. A.G. Stewart has to change the formulation of the steam relaxer and steam deep conditioning hair cream because of the reported problems of the product. Premier had to modify the quality of its Premier larger beer in the 1980s on the basis of the product problem. Dunan Furniture Limited has had to withdraw many of its furniture design on the strength of the reported problem and fear market reaction of the design. Some companies have nevertheless sound to be impressive of the product problem reports. In spite of widening reported failing of its car, Peugeot Automobile Nigeria have not changed, substantially modified or withdrawn its product in the market. The same goes for the company that makes chloromethicol an antimatic with the reported serious side effect. In all, product problem report is important and should be speedily and accurately made to marketing management for the corrective action, which will conduce to enhance value of the product and its willing acceptance by the user. Defective products tarnish the corporate image of the organization and undermine satisfaction, often health of the consumer. New producer report. New products are developed as a replacement for withdrawn or dying ones to support existing one, increase an organization's revenue base, or the capture new market target. They are also often developed to counter the activity of the competitor. If competitors are introducing new products, then a firm will need to introduce a new product to remain competitive. Hardly can a modern business enterprise survive for long with only a product item. New products have to be developed and commercialized with their attendant risk and the cost. As field market operator, salesmen are in position to know when competitors are introducing new product into the market and report accordingly to the management, especially if the new product will outdo their one. By observing existing products and newly introduced ones and armed with the knowledge of the how buyers are reacting to them, salesmen are able to advise management on when to introduce new products and the features they should possess. product idea generated by the salesman have a high chance of getting to the commercialization point, as they will be backed by their practical experience and the knowledge of the buyer's specification and the requirement. Report on competition. Only monopoly organization will not have a strong need for the full knowledge of the competition. Competition here is taken in the generic sense to include all other organizations and produce or sell products that can substitute for an organization's product. Given that the price or other demand stimulating or generating decision of competing organization will affect the demand level for a given firm's product, the imperative for spying and reporting on the competitors becoming apparent in strategic marketing, marketing executive seek to ascertain objectivity and strength and weakness of the competitors with a view to fashioning a market strategy plan that will make advantage of their weakness while accommodating their strengths. The role expectation of the salesman in this respect is to be the in the know of all competitors' immediate and future marketing plan, including their policy, procedure, tactics, and strategy, and report to the management accordingly. Marketing executive need timely and accurate information on the activity of the competitors for a clear-sighted and decisive response reaction that will at least protect the position of their organization and at most enhance their market position. The important information need can be filled if the salesman keep watch and even spy on the competitors and report timely and accurately on them. Customer complaint. Marketers have for the long realized the importance of the repeat purchase. These call for the customer maintenance hinged on the continuous and the deliberate effort on the part of the marketer to the meet customer satisfaction and requirement on the basis of their satisfaction with organization's offering, continued and patronage. Satisfying customer on a continuing basis will require marketers to regularly ascertain their level of the satisfaction and the complaint. Customers can complain about the organization's offering in terms of the product and its associated component, its price and credit terms, it from before, during and after purchase, its after sales service, etc. If customer don't themselves complain openly about an organization's offering, then salesmen have the responsibility to uncover and encourage a buyer to express their reservation or the outright complaint, real or imagined, they may have. If such complaints are not voiced out of the left uncovered and therefore unattended, it is not likely that the buyer will not be satisfied with the offering and continue to buy it, especially if they are a better substitute they can turn to. Uncovering customer complaint and reporting same to the management for consideration and necessary action is a sure way of removing some sources of the customer dissatisfaction and granting customer repeat purchase and ultimately brand loyalty. Customer analysis. Organization wishing to satisfy the needs and wants of their customer need to sufficiently inform about the customer. They need to know who the customers are, where they are, and what they want, why they buy, and how they can be communicated and reached. Salesmen who make contact with the customers are the well-placed to provide the geographic, demographic, and the psychographic and the behavioral data that will help management in understanding customer. Overtime reports on the customer made by the salesman will aid management in the following shift in the competition and character of the customer being served and held it in the responding swiftly and appropriately to the such shifts. Low order report. Salesman make reports on the lost order. Lost order will arise when an old or new customer stops buying from company he used to buy from. It can also arise when a prospect who has been seemingly persuaded to buy from a company suddenly changes his mind and buy from another company. If any of the above situation, the company is a loser. If the rate at which the company loses customers become greater than the rate at which it is gaining them, then the company will suffer net loss of the customers, number of the orders, and perhaps volume of the sales. A company that suffers any of the above misfortune will progressively be losing its market share and profitability. Market management in the circumstance is challenged, if not to avoid losing its customer and or orders, to minimize that rate of the loss. One way of meeting this challenge is to have information that gives the reason for the loss or why the customers are turning to other companies and or product. Salesman can gather this information and should report same to the management. Management should, however, be careful with the information provided by the salesman on the lost order. The reason for the caution is that incompetence or negligence on the part of the salesman may be responsible for the lost order, and salesmen are not likely to submit adverse report on themselves. Other possible reason for the lost order as salesman's report may indicate will include relative performance or quality of the product, BCBs, other competing brands, perceived obsolescence of the product, uncompetitive prices of the product, poor after sales services, etc. If salesman's report identify objectively the reasons for the lost order, then management will be in a position to remedy the situation and prevent further losses of the orders or customer and possibly win back lost customer. Digit report as field works often a long distance removed from the office, salesmen have proved historical to be difficult to monitor or surprise. Yet these people whose performance is crucial to the organization's marketing and sales objective must be effectively supervised to ensure that all time they are working as they are should and meeting the set targets. Because sales manager or the sales supervisor who have the responsibility for the sales force supervision cannot repeatedly follow them in all sales class calls, they have to rely heavily on the indirect supervision anchored on sales visit report written by the salesman to supervise them. It is for this that salesmen are called upon to write reports, sometimes in advance, detailing the calls they have to make, the objective set for the each call, date and time of the call, presentation aids to use, reaction of the customer, prospects, presentation agreement reached with the customer, prospect, promises made, etc. On the basis of the information contained in the visit report, the activity of the salesmen are known and followed. Their efforts measured and results recorded. The astute sales manager or the sales supervisor from a thorough analysis of the visit reports can detect selling area where salesmen are not doing very well and offer suggestion that will guide them in enhancing their performance. Market prospect report management is not just concerned with the present sales. It is also concerned with the future sales for planning and control purposes that will ensure long-run survival and profitability of the organization. As you will know, in business, all organization decisions are based or derived from expected or projected future sales. Purchasing schedule, production schedule, cash flow projection, and even personal schedule are all important organizational decisions that derive from the market prospect expressed often as a sales forecast. If sales forecasting is fundamental in organizational planning process, then it needs to be done properly. Doing it properly raises the question of the credibility and dependability of those who participate in it. Salesmen as accounted ears and eyes of the company in the market, places as well suited to sell that quantity of the product customer are likely to buy in a defined time period and under a given market and market condition in their respective market territory. Salesmen need to be involved in the sales forecasting, not just because of their familiarity with the markets, but because they have the ultimate responsibility of realizing the projected sales figure. It must be noted, however, that not being trained forecast and their realization that their sales target may be based on the forecast sales. Salesmen cannot be wholly trusted to make perfect forecast. Those using salesmen in the forecasting sales should be mindful of the possible unprofessionalism and deliberate underestimation on their part and take measure to accommodate and counter such. The usefulness of using salesmen is getting them to make input into the forecasting process has never been doubted. The challenge is on giving them basic training in the forecasting to make their contribution more meaningful and being part to discern when they deliberately understand the sales potential of their territory. Conclusion, the information gathering function of the salesman has been demonstrated to play a strategic role in the sales and marketing management. The various information they collect from the basis of the organization, appreciation of the dynamics of their macro environment, this helps them to respond appropriately to the threats arising from the changing environment and exploit the opportunity that emerge therein. sales management is challenged to ensure that the salesmen are adept in collection, interpretation, and reporting of the valid and reliable information that will promote future sales of their organization. Relevant information to be meaningful to the management has to be timely and objectively reported. Summary: in this unit, you have been exposed to the following: information gathering function of the salesman, source of the marketing information, salesman and the marketing information gathering, types of the information salesman gather. Tutor mark assignment: discuss the information gathering function of the salesman. List and explain the specific role of the information flow from the consumer to producer within the framework of the marketing management. Describe the types of the information sales gather. References for the reading is given here.